in looking back at the pandemic is how in the darkest days, when we are anxious and don't know what the future holds for us, sometimes in those dark days, it's as if this big dark blanket comes over us and creates this void. And I've always found in my career working in hospitals, anytime you find a dark void, that's where angels appear.
It was a big challenge not being able to have the families there with their loved ones, because at the end of the day, we were able to go home to our families regardless of the type of day or situation that we had. And it was a challenge to know that these family members couldn't come in to see their loved ones.
When he was in CCU and he was sedated, and I asked his male nurse, I believe his name was Tony, I asked him, you know, do you talk to him when you go in there? Do you tell him what today, the day is? Do you, you know, just fill him in on what the weather is? Anything? He's like, oh yeah, I talked to him. I said, will you let him know that his wife Pam told him today is going to be a good day?
Being that extension to be there with that patient and be able to connect with the family, you know, via the iPad, those were rewarding moments because even though they couldn't physically be there, they were still there.
Those angels appeared in the stories I heard about nurses just taking time to hold the hands of patients. The stories I heard about nurses FaceTiming with family in the ICU when the patient had been weeks without being able to see their family. The stories I heard about staff helping each other don and doff. The stories I heard about support at home for each other. These angels appeared because of the better human nature of people. And crisis, I think, creates this void that allows angels to come out. And we just have so many angels in our organization that are worth celebrating.